All right, stay tuned. In this episode, I'm going to show you some of what I did to restore this vintage go-kart from the 60s. This is a Rupp DartKart with a Homelite KL-92 engine. Do a better job of grinding all of this these pits out, any rust. There's not much rust mainly, it's just crappy welds.
Hey, I keep finding spots I've missed.
All right, I'm painting this thing right away after I got done stripping all the paint off of it, welding on the lower or rear bumper and axle mount. I want to get it primed, and before I put the floorboard in, I want to prime it, and then I'll just grind the little places where I do the stitch welding before I put the floorboard in. I want to get it primed, get some of these. The only pits that were on this metal were between where the floorboard was welded on and the tubing, so I want to get it all primed and get some of the pits removed before I put the floorboard in. That way I can sand it easier. All right, just got in these my chrome parts I had sent off back in September. They are the steering wheel and the four outer sections of the rim. Here they are, just got them unwrapped, picked them up today, placed in Cambridge City called Custom Metal Finishing of Indiana. They're in Cambridge City, Indiana, which is close to me. They're just too big for my chrome tanks. I just do screws and small microphone parts. But they were pitted pretty bad, and they turned out really good, as you can tell. I powder coated these the turbine sections myself. Did the chrome from the Custom Metal Finish. The original rubber around here, I'll have to figure out what to do there. I'm guessing just have to polish it up with maybe some Armor All. There's no cracks or anything, it just kind of got some aged looking to it. But yes, chrome turned out really good on the steering wheel. So original Rupp steering wheel, re-chromed, go right there. I'm still in the midst of working on the chassis. I've got the floor pan over here that I'm had cut out for me. I want to wait and put it in after I get done sanding out. There's a few little pits and imperfections, so I'm going to sand it, prime it, get it down to a straight looking piece of metal. It's a lot easier to sand this thing once the floor pan's out. So I'll get it close, then I'll weld the floor pan in, seal it one more time, and then paint the whole thing. Haven't decided on what color yet. I'm thinking red, but not sure. Later, I'm still working on this go-kart for my son. He's actually, when I first started this project, he was small enough to drive it. Now he's too big to operate it, so It's taking longer than I've expected. Just life gets in the way. So anyway, getting ready to weld in. I'm gonna tack the floor pan in. And then once it's all tacked, I'll go through and stitch weld it. If I can find my glove. It's good enough. Got it clamped in the back where it's important. Now reclamp it in front when I'm ready. Okay, zoom in. Here it is, my little go-kart frame rotisserie. It's made out of an engine stand. I'm not using the engine stand anymore. So figure I would turn it into something useful. Weld it up, bolted some brackets on. And this makes painting this frame much easier. Just got done raining. It's a glorious day. Perfect for painting. As long as it doesn't sprinkle. Okay, we got the steering wheel snugged down. I'm gonna assemble this thing in my living room because run out of room in the shop right now. I've got a lot of projects in the works, so can't really use my shop, and it might scratch the frame. So I'm gonna put it together on this soft carpet. First thing I'm gonna do is assemble the rear end. I think I got all the parts laid out. Ridge facing up, and these kingpins are better than what you can buy anywhere today, so I re-chromed the originals. These are the original kingpin bolts.
tricky doing this in the living room since there's gonna be grease. This is the only grease I got, it's this high temp waterproof grease, so that'll have to do. Gotta be careful. Alright, so I'm satisfied with how good that's greased up. Now, you can say this faces down like this. That goes in. And then there's a lock nut underneath. I got done with the Rupp DartKart. Turned out fairly good. It's got a Homelite KL-92 engine. I got a place if I wanted to put another motor mount, I could put two engines, but don't have the I would need a direct drive engine, which would be the KR-92 to make a match set left and right. Although this is on the right because the brake drum's on the left, so I couldn't put the engine on the left where it belongs. This really needs the, I'm not sure how they would do that. There's not even enough room to put the sprocket further out. So, not quite sure how you put Homelite engines on the Rupp DartKarts. As you can see, I'm too big for it, and I'm 6'3". So, I always wanted one when I was a kid, so now I've got one. Now I'm going to probably end up selling it, because I really have no use for it, other than if I just want to hang it up and display it. My son outgrew it while we were building it, so he's kind of too big to ride it also, although he's shorter than I am, so he should be able to ride it if he wanted to. He wants to run it, but I don't want to put gas in it, because if I put gas in it, then I won't be able to store it inside like right here. So I guess the best I can do is push myself around the living room. Anyway, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, click the like button, click the little bell down at the bottom right so it reminds you when I have a new video coming out. They won't all be about stuff like this. I have a variety on my website, from chainsaws to RCA microphones to vintage broadcast gear to new broadcast gear to slot cars and you name it. It's a wide variety. It's like more of a man channel than anything. Fishing, hunting, guns, you name it. All right, now I'm going to try to get myself off of this thing. Peace. Ow, ow, ow. Ooh.